Hello guys, in this lecture we will study about SQL views. Views are actually objects just like tables, but there is a bit difference between tables and views. Tables are used to store data while views are used to view the data that is stored in tables. We can define views as these are virtual tables that do not store any data of their own but display data stored in other tables. Actually, view itself doesn't store any data, but it extracts or selects data from one or more tables. Views are just SQL queries. Usually we put select queries in views. Views can contain all or a few rows from a single table or from multiple tables. It depends upon the select query which we have inserted or which we have used in the view. In MySQL, view can show data from one or many tables. We can work on views in different ways. We can create a new view. We can drop an existing view. We can check the content of a view. We can say that the statement which has been used by the view. We can rename a view, and also we can update an existing view. A new view can be created by using the create query as we did for creating tables. So we must type create view, then name of that view, and after that we must supply the select statement, and before the select statement we must type as. So the syntax for creating a view is create view, view name, as, and then select statement. So this new view will actually hold the data that can be produced by this select statement. So we are actually making an object that will keep the result of a select statement. Sometimes we need to type a lengthy or complex select statement repeatedly. So to avoid that repetition, we create a view and keep that select statement saved in that view. Here we have two examples for creating view. In the first example, the name of view which will be created is std names, and it has a simple select query. This query will get the values for name attribute from student database, and inside this database we have a table basic info. So there might be many attributes in basic info, so this query will get only the values for name attribute, and the result will be stored in std names view. In second case, we are making a new view and we name it as student from kpk, and this view is using a bit longer select statement. So it is actually using natural join between basic info and contact info. Basic info and contact info, these are two tables, and we have also a where clause in this statement. So according to this select statement, we will get registration number, name, and province from two different tables. The first table is basic info, the second table is contact. These both tables are connected. They might have registration number as common, and we also put a condition with where clause that the province must be KPK. There might be students from other provinces, so the result will give us the registration name and province from these two tables, and the promise must be KPK. Now we will practice these two queries in our SQL workbench. So here we have a database named as student. It has three tables and there is no view in the student database. So first we need to select this database, use student, control enter. The student has been selected. Now we know that there is no view and there are only three tables, but through code we can also check this thing. So I must type show full tables. We will get the names of all tables. In case if there is any view, then we will get also that view in this list. And here we will have view instead of base table. So if suppose there is a view, then we want to filter the result and we want to get only the views. So for that purpose we must type show full table where table type equals view. So this result will give us the list of all views. Here note one thing, the table type it has capital letters in its values, so the view will also be in uppercase. So we must type this view in uppercase. Control enter. Since there is no view, so there is no value in the result. Now we are going to create a new view. So before creating a new view, first we will type the select statement and check the result, and then we will put that select statement in the new created view. So here I type select static from contact info, basic info. We have some results in the basic info table. So we have here three attributes. I need only name. So we got the values for name only. Now I'm going to create a new view and I will use this select statement in that new view. So for this purpose we must type create view. These are keywords. And now I will type std names. This is the view name. And then we have another class that is as. So the query is create view std name as select name from basic info. This is the select statement and this one is creating a new view named as std names. This view has been created as I executed the statement. So if we refresh the list, we will get this std names under views. We can also check this view by executing the show full tables where table type equals view. Look, we have std name here in the list and its type is view. Now we can use this new view just like we use the tables for select statement. So here I must type select static from std names. This will give us the same result as we get with the select statement which is used in this view. Now we are going to type a bit lengthier statement. We will have a natural join in it. Here in the student database we have two tables, contact info and basic info. First we will check the contents of basic info. So I'm typing select static from basic info executed by pressing Control Enter. So we have three attributes and some records. Now check the contents of contact info. In contact info, we have registration number, same as we have in the basic info. Then we have phone, email, city, province, and country. Now I need a list of students from KPK only. So the list must have student name, registration number, and the province. So for that purpose, I must use a select statement with natural join. Natural join, because we are using registration number in both tables, and with the help of this registration number, both tables are connected. So here I must type select. I need name. I need let's say registration number. So first I need to type registration number, then name, and then province from. The first table is basic info, and natural join. Second table is contact info. With the help of this query, we will get a list of students from both the tables. In the list, we will have registration number, name, and province. We got this list, registration number and name. These two attributes came from basic info, and province came from contact info. Now I need the list of students from KPK only. So here I must type where province equals KPK, executed, Control Enter. So here we got the list of students from KPK only. So this is a query having natural join between basic info and contact info, and also using a where clause. So I am using this query in a view. So I need to create a new view. So create view, and here I type student from KPK, and then as after that I need this query to be used in this view. So I'm typing it here. So we have create view std from KPK as, then the select query we used for getting this list. We are executing it. Control Enter. This view has been created. We can check it here. Refresh. We got it here. STD from KPK. We can also check this view with the help of this show full table statement. We got it here in the list. STD from KPK. Its table type is view. Now I can use this view just like a table for select statement. So I'm typing select static from std from KPK. We got the same result as we were getting from this select statement. But now if you look into the effort, last time we typed this much statement, and this time we are typing a very shorter statement. So it is possible that we need this statement several times. So to avoid time consumption, we can easily type this shorter statement. Also, we can filter this results by using some additional clauses. For example, I am typing here where name like The name must start with A. So here, with the help of this statement, we will get those students whose names are starting with A, and all the students will be from KPK as per the previous or as per the used select statement. We got two names, both are starting with A. We can also apply something else, like I can order these names. So here I must type order by name. Now these names are ordered.